try. See them left side.
All right, guys. So this is screaming right. We're gonna make a series of moves here. We drop down one, and then we're gonna turn the boat and then boogie away from the second ledge. Okay.
Drop down
if
one, boogie away.
If I say lean into the boat on this one, like brace yourselves really good in the boat. If I say hold on. So normally you can hold on. Go all forward one and rest.
Close to that rock. Nice.
It's rapid at high water, so it's a big wave train. That will shoot on that rock this way and then zigzags back into that hole. My first trip ever, I got my whole boat of 10 recirculated in that hole there, so our boat was stuck getting worked in this hole and it never wanted to let us go. So horrible.
Yeah.
don't catch this pool down here. And like, I've seen it to a point where there's like a wave train all the way through the pool into the next rapid. Like, you are hauling coming through here. I've seen, we had swimmers once up in here. And we saw like a group of six float by, not on their boat, holding onto the perimeter line, beer in the water, no PFDs on, upside down boat, flying into people. Like, Jesus. Sitting like way up here on the bank. Like, what the fuck are you doing? Go off work! Dig it in, guys! Oh!
Was that a rock we went over? What'd you do?
We just hit the current line going really fast sideways. Same thing as the normal.
Sweet.
Let's go offward. How are we making fun of the little water? Man, right. So that green rock right there, that thing creates a wave called Rosie's. Like I said, that hydraulic pattern always digs out the rocks here, so it's like 60 to 70 feet deep here at high water.
Shit.
So all that water's coming over the rock, and what it creates is a surging hydraulic. So the wave will be 5 feet tall, 5 feet tall, and then all of a sudden it'll be like a 10-foot tall wave there. That's why we don't run these boats, is because there are whirlpools the size of this boat on the other side of that wave. One of those big boats back there flipped when I was a rookie. This kid Cody fell off the front, didn't grab onto this perimeter line. See the red line?
Yeah.
Like, missed it as he was falling out of the boat. Got pulled underneath here, didn't come up till around the corner here, like kind of in that flat water. Wasn't wearing these tennis shoes that he had tied onto his feet, and wasn't wearing the board shorts that were tied onto the outside of his dry suit. Was probably underwater for 45 seconds. Came up gasping, I want to go home. Like an 18-year-old corn fed boy.
The one
first time away from home is a little rough. And so do a lot of the other boats. It's kind of the swim of 2014. And rest. But I like to hear how differently he tells it compared to how differently we all tell it. He just didn't understand that nature could do that to him, you know? He was like one of those kids on the boat that's like, let's flip the boat! Dude, you're going to be the one crying if we flip the boat. Yeah.
How many runs they make you do in like training, like before you take out the boat on your own?
It's like 30 plus.
Cool.
You do a whole month of it. So like what you do is you come for a week.
Yeah.
You'll do swift water training, an overnight trip with us. It's called the rookie overnight.
Hmm.
And then you're a rookie, so you're unpaid labor.
Sure.
You come up here, you sit on boats, go really broke. Don't make any money, just like sitting along. So we'd have like, I would just be on the boat, like, okay, like, Patches was a rookie this year, I'd be like, okay, Patches is your guy, I'm just gonna sit here, you hear my voice over Patches, listen to my voice.
Right.
And we're gonna see how it goes, and they do that probably, hopefully 5 or 6 times, and then you get to do what's called a checkoff run, where you have to run the whole stretch, top to bottom, don't hit any rocks, miss all the, like, fun stuff.
Sure.
They give you a boat that you have to miss everything with. Like, you gotta miss Freddy. You actually have to go to the right of Freddy on your checkoff run because it's harder to do. And they want to make sure that you can make a hard move like that.
Yeah.
Like, when I checked off, the big move was making screaming right all the way through and missing jaws. That's why on my first trip, I learned more than I did in all of training when I was suddenly recirculated in jaws. Like, oh my god. I blew that one really bad. Don't panic. Don't ever panic. It was a weird trip, though. It was the weirdest first trip ever. I was like, I can't do this. What the fuck?